resurrection. But we also gather to remember and to give thanks for the life of Frederick Carl Smith. Fred, as you all know, was a remarkable man. A man loved and appreciated by a wide range of people, as evidenced here today. His was a life lived in service to his country, his family, his friends, and the countless numbers of people all around the world. I suspect that it was his own upbringing and his exposure to the teachings of the Dutch Reformed Church that helped to shape and inform his strong sense of service. But Fred was a no-nonsense kind of man, a man with a low tolerance for wasted words and actions. He had a way of sizing things up and cutting to the chase so that everyone around him knew what he thought and why he thought it, and in most cases, why they should think it as well. To the uninitiated, this might sound like a rather boastful, arrogant sort of man, but nothing could be farther from the truth. You see, Fred preferred to work quietly and behind the scenes, helping others to do their jobs more efficiently and effectively, rather than seeking the limelight for himself. In other words, he took his work seriously without taking himself so seriously. It helped that Fred had a great sense of humor. That, coupled with his work ethic, helped to endear him to many, many people. You see, Fred genuinely loved people, no matter what their station was in life, and it showed. He reached out to others in a very personal and winsome way, engaging nurses and aides and wait staff right alongside of generals and ambassadors and heads of state. Fred had a zest for life that was contagious. He was a bit of a sports fanatic, and he enjoyed being outdoors. He enjoyed baseball and running marathons and playing tennis and simply hiking around in the woods. And they had it on fairly good authority that he tended to be a bit competitive. So much so that he even managed to turn the normally more mundane sport of shuffleboard into something of a spectacle. You'll want to ask the family about that if you don't know him already. Now, as most of you know, Fred was also a loving and devoted family man. Peggy and Tiffany and Tammy were the loves of his life. He adored them, and he showered them with affection in many different ways as they did for him. And it was that kind of give and take that led him to experience many new things in his life, some wonderful and, well, some not so wonderful, at least for him. This was certainly true when it came to the animal world. I'm thinking here about a willful horse named Pepper and a winsome dog named Bogey. Well, I could go on, but there are others here today who are more interested in firsthand knowledge of Fred. So allow me to welcome General Sheehan and Mr. Grizzell and Dr. Haas to the pulpit to help us recall some of the attributes of Fred that we belong.
Fred, Christianity looks like a tapestry of America with threads, common gold thread. If you were a friend of Fred, it made no difference how long you were out of D.C. When you came back, it was as if you had never left. You were invited to breakfast or to dinner at Fred and Ted's. But I need to tell you, there were rules associated with these events. If it was breakfast, you had to remember when it was your turn to pay. It made no difference how long you were out of town. If you did not remember, Fred did. What we discussed at breakfast came with the group, no matter how sensitive. We call that the 5:30 rule. If any member of the group needed help with anything, Fred organized the appropriate response, and you were expected to participate. If you came to dinner at 118 South Fayette Street, you needed to be up on current events and be prepared for any type of a question, such as, if you could have dinner with any person in the room, living or dead, who would it be and why? Or more recently, how many countries are there in the world? The real inquisition started after you gave your answer. If you think you know the answer to that question, at the reception, you might want to ask Bob. Bob is the guy with the baseball tie. He's Fred's brother. He'll tell you the incorrect answer. Fred loved to understand each of us as a person. He wanted to know how our kids were and what made us sick. The proof of this was during the last weeks of his life. One of the last projects we worked on together was to address the mail out of his books on visiting presidential libraries. In that book, Fred wrote a personal message to every recipient. Like everything he did, there was a Fred system. There were two black, fine point, delicate pens. One was red, one was mid. One medium, delicate, and red. The envelopes were from Staples, and we required two $1 stamps and 1 5-cent stamp. Fred had a master roster of names inside each name drew a small box. I could check the box only after the book was signed, placed in the envelope, and sealed. I addressed the envelopes by hand. The thought of using address labels never occurred to Fred. Top left-hand corner, Frederick C. Smith, 118 South Fayette Street, Alexandria, Virginia, 22314. Then your address. And on the bottom, in the right-hand corner, in red felt tip pen, was the first class name. At the time we were doing this, the Major League Baseball playoffs were going on. So we watched baseball and worked on the distribution of the book. The process that I would complete is that I would complete an envelope, hand it to Fred, and tell him the name of the person. Fred would take a few moments to reflect on you as a person and his relationship with you. Once he completed his inscription, he talked about each of you in a very loving and thoughtful way. Each person in this room held a special place in Fred's heart. Because of his declining health, we could only complete a limited number at any one time. So it was a tension turn for the game on TV. The announcer would say something about the Phillies, and Fred would say, we need to get Fox Fallon over here for the next Phillies game. If a question came up, we did not know a baseball question came up, we didn't know the answer, we would call David Berto. How many of you know what Ron Washington's Major League batting average was? He was a shortstop. David does. Cousin Jim, who lives in St. Louis, was called on at all hours to give us inside scoop